Today, we will discuss about the various factors which improve the physical stability of animals. Now, already we know the two main mechanisms which are very important for stability of animals, that are Brownian movement and sedimentation, that is Stokes' law. So already we have studied about that Stokes' law. So the two main theory behind this, one is Brownian movement and Stokes' law. Now, here some factors are there which can improve the stability of one emulsion. One by one, we will discuss about that. The first factor, that is particle size, or in cases of emulsion, that is globule size. As the globule size is reduced in cases of emulsion, what will happen? They will tend to exhibit Brownian movement. For example, we can say microemulsion, because in cases of microemulsion, the globule size, that is 0.01 micrometer. So as the globule size is reduced, they will tend to exhibit the Brownian movement. Same in cases of Stokes' law, what we have seen, the diameter of the globule is considered as the major factor in creaming of emulsion. In last class, we have discussed about the creaming. And there also we have seen the diameter of the globule, that is considered as a major factor in cases of creaming of emulsion. In general, the rate of creaming, that will decreases fourfold when the globule diameter is half. Again, I am repeating, in last class in creaming also I have discussed about that the rate of creaming decreases fourfold when the globule diameter is halved. In microemulsion, the rate of creaming is insignificant. So it is necessary to choose the optimum globule size for maximum stability upon emulsion. On the industrial scale, emulsion are passed through a colloidal mill. Now already all of you know what is colloidal mill. In pharmaceutical engineering subject, in size reduction chapter, you have studied about colloidal mill. So in industrial scale, if emulsions are passed through a colloidal mill, so the globule size, that can be reduced. After preparations and during aging of emulsion, that are also evaluated for globule size. So first factor is globule size. Second factor, particle size distribution. In practical also already you have performed the particle size distributions. In general, the globules of uniform size, or also you can say that is mono size, they will impart maximum stability of one emulsion. In such emulsions, globules pack loosely, and all that globule to globule contact, that will be very much less. However, it is very difficult to achieve a monodispersed system. Why? Because variety of factors such as viscosity, phase volume ratio, density of phase, all are the factors. So it is very difficult to achieve a monodispersed system. Hence, an optimum degree of size dispersion range, that should be chosen to achieve maximum physical stability. Now, if the size of globules are not uniform, what will happen? Globules of smaller size, they will occupy the void space between the larger globules. Because of this reason, this type of closed packing, which induces greater cohesion of globules, cohesive energy, that will increase, which leads to coalescence. In last class already we have discussed about that, what is coalescence. So this type of closed packing, which induces greater cohesion of globules, which leads to coalescence. Size distribution analysis, that has been a common procedure in the evaluations of physical stability of emulsion. So this is all about globule size distribution. Third factor, viscosity. Viscosity, that is another one important factor to get a good emulsion or to improve the physical stability of an emulsion. As the viscosity increases, flocculation of globules, that will be reduced, because the mobility of globules is restricted because of increasing viscosity. Same, simultaneously, the Brownian movement of globules will also be hindered, leading to creaming here also. So due to this antagonistic effect, and optimum viscosity is desirable for good stability. Viscosity factor, that is normally considered for the industrial production of emulsion. So to increase that viscosity of external phase, we can add various thickening agent such as tragacanth, vegum and cellulose derivative. Cellulose derivative example, methyl cellulose, carboxymethyl cellulose. So if we add this thickening agent, the viscosity of external medium will increases. That are employed to formulate emulsion for internal use. For example, O by W type of emulsion. What will happen? Long chain fatty acid and or alcohol such as beeswax, stearic acid, stearyl alcohol that are used when oil is continuous phase in an emulsion. So viscosity determination is an important quality control tool for evaluations of our product or emulsion. Next factor, that is phase volume ratio. This is another one important factor to improve the physical stability of an emulsion. In an emulsion, the relative volume of water and oil, that is expressed as phase volume ratio. The volume of water and oil. In general, most medicinal emulsions that are prepared with a volume ratio of 50-50. This proportion brings about loose packing of globules. Uniform spherical globules in loose packing have a porosity of 48% of the bulk volume. The remaining volume, how much? 52%, that is occupied by the globules. The upper limit, that is 74% of oil that can be incorporated in an emulsion, but this may lead to breaking of the emulsion. So this value is referred to as critical point of phase volume ratio. Maximum percent is 74. So what is the definitions of critical point? Critical point is defined as the concentration of internal phase. Remember, the concentration of internal phase above which the emulsifying agent cannot produce a stable emulsion of desired type. That is known as critical point. Beyond the critical point, the globules become irregular in shape. So the packing of globules is closest, which leads to coalescence, and it will directly decrease the stability of emulsion. Next factor, charges of electrical double layer. Charges of electrical double layer. When ionic type of emulsifying agents are used, the electrical double layer means interface between the oil and water, which possesses charge. The repulsive force due to like charge on the surface of the globules prevent the flocculation or aggregations of the globules. The charge on the electrical double layer also depends on the pH of the preparation. So pH of emulsion, that is another one important factor. In general, the influence of charge of electrical double layer is of secondary importance. But when non-ionic emulsifiers are used, this factor has no importance. So charges of the electrical double layer, this factor, when it is important, when we are using ionic type of emulsifying agent. When non-ionic type of emulsifying agents are used for preparation of emulsion, this factor has no importance. Next factor, physical properties of interface. The interfacial film of the emulsifier, that is the responsible for increasing the stability of the product. What? The interfacial film of the emulsifying agent, that is responsible for increasing the stability of the emulsion. The film which formed, that should be elastic enough to form rapidly as well as droplets are produced. This behavior facilitates the production of emulsion. So whatever film is formed, that should be elastic enough to form rapidly as soon as droplets are formed. Similarly, on moderate shaking, the emulsion should be redistributed or reconstituted. After manufacture of emulsion, the film should be so tough that coalescence of globules can be prevented. So the toughness of the globules, that is important part. After manufacturing of one emulsion, the film should be tough so that the coalescence of globules can be prevented. So for that, suitable emulsifying agent, for example various surfactant, that should be selected to achieve the above film properties at the interface. The physical properties of interface depends on the pH of the preparations. In last factor already I told. So therefore, optimum pH has to be maintained for maximum stability. Okay, so selection of emulsifying agent as well as the pH of the final product, these two are important to get the maximum stability of one emulsions. Next factor, density of the phases. Oil phase density that can be increased by adding brominated oil when the oil is an external phase in cases of O by W type of emulsifying agent. But it is not an usual practice to adjust the density of the phases to the same value. So for that, paraffin, vegetable oil, that density that can be enhanced by adding some brominated oil when oil is an external phase. Next factor, temperature fluctuation. For stability of an emulsion, temperature is another one factor. Elevated temperature that can alter the partition characteristics of one emulsifying agent as well as preservative what we have used for preparations of emulsion. The net result, that is instability. Temperature that can also increase the chemical degradations of drugs also. Whatever drug or medicament that is present inside the emulsion that can degrade because of increasing the temperature. Not only medicament, some the other ingredients that are used for preparations of emulsion also, that can also be degraded by increasing temperature. So the chemical instability also leads to physical instability. At higher temperature, the external phase water that may evaporate, so which make the product more concentrated. Obviously, in cases of O by W type of emulsion, water is the external phase. So by increasing the temperature, the water that will evaporate, so the prepared emulsion that will be more concentrated. At lower temperature, the aqueous phases may contain ice crystal. In cases of higher temperature, water will evaporate. In cases of lower temperature, the external phase, that means water, that may contain ice crystal, which also rupture the interfacial film and break the emulsion. So during the preparations of emulsion, care should be taken to prevent temperature fluctuation, and as well as the for storage of emulsion, the temperature is one of the important factors, so we have to care about that. Another one factor is there to get maximum stability that I have not included here, that is poor experimental technique. Whatever technique we are following to get a good emulsion, that experimental technique, that is also one important factor. These often leads to incomplete emulsification. So the process condition, including the sequence of steps, should be meticulously followed during manufacturing of that emulsion. So how to add, when to add, drop by drop we have to add that oil phase, or when emulsifying agents are added, everything is important. So step by step if we follow, then we will get a good emulsion. Beside that, factors mentioned above, it is also important to prevent the growth of microorganisms also. So we have to choose the preservative in such a way that it should partition in oil phase as well as water phase also. So this is all about the various factors which can improve the physical stability of one emulsion. Next we will discuss about the phase inversion. What is phase inversions? Phase inversion means a changes of emulsion type from O by W to W by O or vice versa. In instability marker, already you have studied about that phase inversions. So just I am repeating, phase inversion means a changes of emulsion type of O by W to W by O or vice versa. in cases I have already given one example, that is cold cream. So phase inversion, that can be obtained by two methods. See that first method, that is changing the chemical nature of emulsifier, and second, altering the phase volume ratio. In cases of chemical nature of emulsifier, an O by W type of emulsion is prepared, for example, that is sodium stearate. Now in this emulsion, if we add calcium chloride, then calcium stearate will form, which is oil soluble. So first we have prepared O by W type of emulsion by using sodium stearate. Then I have added calcium chloride. So it will directly react with sodium stearate and it will form calcium stearate. But calcium stearate, that is oil soluble, not water soluble. Therefore, oil phase becomes the continuous phase and W by O emulsion is produced. One best example for that, white liniment. In dispensing pharmacy, you have prepared this white liniment. So in that cases, phase inversions will occur. Second, altering the phase volume ratio. By changing the phase volume ratio, the phase inversion, that can also be done. In this method, O by W type of emulsifying agent is mixed with an oil. The emulsifying agent type is O by W type, that is mixed with an oil, and then a small amount of water is added. So what will happen? The volume of water, that is very small compared to the oil. So W by O type of emulsion will be formed. As more water is added slowly, the inversion point is gradually reached and the water as well as emulsifier envelop the oil to small globules, which yield an O by W type of emulsion. If the method is not properly controlled, phase inversion can give a bad emulsion, which can cause the considerable difficulty in manufacturing of emulsion. So this is all about phase inversions. Next we will go for study of stability. The study of stability of emulsion means chemical stability as well as physical stability. Chemical stability means it includes the study of degradations of active drugs or emulsifying agent or whatever preservatives I have used, or if I use any antioxidant. So degradations of that additives as well as medicament, that is all about the chemical stability of emulsion. And physical stability means it includes the study of shelf life, obtain its form on moderate shaking, etc. So for study of stability, here 2 points are there. First point is extent of phase separations and second one is globule size distribution. Extent of phase separation means the practical and commercial aspect of stability, that is the study of phase separation. This is very quick method and it can be applied for poorly formed and rapidly breaking emulsion. Separation of phases is visible after a definite period of time, though the sign of instability begin quite early. In cases of globule size distributions, an early sign of instability is indicated by the appearance of bigger size globules. After preparation, if we see the bigger size globules in the formulations, that is the indications of instability. This is due to aggregation and coalescence of small globules from time to time during the storage. Therefore, microscopic examination of globule size distribution analysis, that is one useful tool to evaluate the physical stability of any emulsion. So already the particle size determinations by optical microscopy all of you have performed. The same in cases of emulsion, we have to determine the globule size of that particular emulsion time to time. This method is similar to the procedure described in particle size analysis by optical microscopy. Globule size in micrometer, that can be plotted on the x-axis and the frequency on y-axis. Same type of graph already you have performed in microscopy practical. Immediately after manufacture, the emulsion exhibit active coalescence stage for some period. During this active coalescence stage, the emulsion gets stabilized and is relieved of the stresses induced in the preparations. Beyond this period, the emulsion remains stable on extended storage. So from that curve, see that in x-axis time has been taken, and on y-axis depth of the globules in ultracentrifuge cell. What is that? That is accelerated stability testing for one emulsion. Accelerated stability testing. In cases of emulsion, accelerated stability study has been performed because that is one evaluation parameter for physical stability of emulsion. Normally, flocculation and creaming are slow process. However, this process can be increased by inducing stress condition, for example, centrifugations. So if we use ultra centrifuge, in that cases, flocculations and creaming, this process that can be increased. From that curve, we can say that in x-axis time that has been taken, and y-axis depth of oil in ultracentrifuge cell that is taken, and one graph that has been drawn. Now here A, B, C, D, four curves are there. Curve A, that is one bad emulsion. B, C and D, that are good emulsions. From where we will get it? Because after ultracentrifugations, there will be separations of oil and water phase. So by using one ultracentrifuge, if we maintain the speed 2000 to 3000 RPM at room temperature, then it will be separated. At different time period, we have to see how much oil or how much water that is separated. A bad emulsion separate the oil instantly, but in cases of, if it is a good emulsion, does not exhibit detectable separations of oil phase until certain time period, and that time is known as induction period. Okay, so this is all about the evaluation parameter for prepared emulsion. Thank you.